Alright folks, here we are again, another little how-to video. Today we're going to be making loads for coal hoppers, or you can do this for gondolas too. Nice little method I picked up a while ago. I've been doing it for some time. Some of the loads I've made have been around for about 10-15 years. It's a nice inexpensive way to do things. There are guys out there that make commercial loads. Those loads are nice, but these are quick and easy. And if you have a lot of cars like I do, you might not have the funds right away to use all the commercial loads. So this method, you'll be able to make loads that are relatively inexpensive. So what you're going to need is you're going to need the cars that you need to put the loads in. This is a top gun. It comes without a load. The secret to this method is you're going to need air conditioning weather seal. In this case, I'm using one that's 1/4 inch by 1/4 inch. That's perfect. I don't know if they did it intentionally, but that's the size of it, and it fits perfectly inside most HO scale hoppers and gondola cars. You're going to need the foam. You're going to need a nice sharp pair of scissors. You're going to need some spray adhesive. I like using the 3M Super 77. There's other spray adhesives out there, but I like using this one. And then you're going to need your coal material. You can use a lot of it out there. I like to use some real stuff. So this is ballast, slack coal from Scenic Express. They used to sell the Smith & Sons, who I prefer. But this is still a natural product. You could also use Woodland Scenics, or Plastrick also sells some material, I believe. You can even use, if you're not doing coal loads, in this case I'm doing coal loads, so this is actually coal. If you're doing sand or stone, you can actually use sand or stone that you can pick up from your home center. You know, a bottle like this is enough to do several fleets of cars. Right. And then you're going to need a pair of gloves to protect your hands from the spray glue. And then what I like to use to hold the foam while I apply the glue is a hemostat. And you can get these from the guys at the train shows, the tool guys. You know, you get a few of these for a couple of bucks. You can also use an old pair of pliers. I like using the hemostat because it locks shut once you clamp it onto the foam. And this just cleans up real nice with some either mineral spirits or like turpentine when all is said and done. So once you have the car that you want to put the coal load in, you take your foam, you put it inside the car. You can measure this out too. You make your mark, and using a nice sharp pair of scissors, you just cut the load. See, I'm doing this one-handed. And what this does is now this gives you your blank. And as you can see, that's a lot of foam. What I like to do is I'll cut this in half. Cut in half, and what this does now is it gives you two blanks. Okay, you can test fit it along the way. See, it fits inside the car. Now what you do is you're going to trim this to the profile of whatever material you're going to load. Coal, stone, they all have little difference in angles of repose if you want to get that technical with it. I just like to look at some prototype pictures, and I give it a nice little bevel on either end. That's where the sharp scissors come in handy. You sit there and you can sculpt with this, and let me show you what one of those look like when it's done. So after you carve it, sculpt it away with the scissors, you can see I bevel the edges, bevel the sides. If you look at it from the side profile or along the edges, it's starting to kind of resemble. In this case, it'll be a coal load. And once again, it fits nicely inside the body of the car. Now what's nice about this is you can do a bunch of these at once. As you can see, for tonight's, for this project here, I have 14 car worth of Top Guns I'm going to be doing, and I have some old LBF coal porters that need loads too. So that's what these are for. Now cars like this Top Gun, they don't have, well, they have interior bracing, but it lays low, so the coal load will sit above this. But some of the cars, like the coal porters, have internal bracing that sits kind of high. So what you're going to do is, and what you can do is, you can notch out where that bracing is. So when you make the load and then you go to put it in the car, it'll fit over that internal bracing. Okay, so now that we have our blanks and we're all ready to go, we've done our sculpting. Now it's time to start covering this in spray glue and then covering this in your simulated load material. In this case, I'm going to be using coal. Okay, so here we are. I have my blank. I have my hemostat clamped on the back. Again, like I said, you can use an old pair of pliers. So this is ready now. There's my glue, and there's my material. I usually use an old Athen box lid, but of course, making the video, I can't find my trusty Athen box, old blue box lid. So I'm just using this container that I found down here in the garage. One thing's important about this stuff, and all these spray adhesives, make sure you do this in a well-ventilated area, because this stuff, don't do it in the house. Do it outside, do it in the garage, do it out back. It has a high odor, and it's somewhat flammable. So you just want to take a few precautions. Treat it like you would if you're using a rattle can or your spray booth. Don't do this in your spray booth. Trust me, I've learned from experience. It takes a lot to clean this stuff up, because it's going to get places where you didn't think it could get. I just know that from experience, unfortunately. So again, since I'm using the video and I didn't bring my tripod, I have it attached to my hemostat, and I'm going to coat the spray foam in glue. Okay, there it is. Well coated. Soaked in nicely. Maybe I'll give it a little shot on the other side here. Just make sure I get nice even coated. Okay. Now I'm going to help this along, because it works good wet, but it's better when it's tacky. So I'll just let it help it along. Let it dry a little bit. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it in my coal. Again, this goes better when you're using two hands. Let's see if we can do it this way. Also trying not to get the glue on my little video camera here. Now you can apply this once, see what happens. You can let it dry, give it a second coat of glue if you wanted to, and build up the layer. Usually it doesn't require that. Let's see what it looks like. Yeah, that's pretty good coverage. I'll let it get tacky a little bit more, and I'll just give it a little touch here. A little touch there. And now, there it is, all coated. Foam's all ready to go. Now I'm going to set this aside to dry. Okay, this is going to take probably, depending on what the temperature is out, it'll take anywhere between 4 and 6 hours to fully dry, so it's not tacky anymore. So here we have, for a night's worth of work, 14 Top Guns worth of loads and 12 coal porters worth of coal loads. I'll leave them out here now to dry up. As you can see, well, it's not too bad. From that big container, I don't know if you can really see it here, but I used maybe top portion. So as I said, this little quart container lasts several unit trains lifetimes. Like I said, I like this method. It's inexpensive. You know, the ballast material is probably around 12 bucks at the show. The glue, spray glue, was about $16 at the home center. The foam itself, one pack, was $2. I used two packs for this project, and I have some left over. The longest amount of time it takes is for you to actually cut and sculpt the foam to the right profile, or to the profile that you think looks pretty good. This stuff is still wet, but let's see if I can pick one that's not so tacky. You know, and it looks pretty good. And you can see, it looks loose, but it's glued on there pretty good. Now, after these dry, I'll shake them loose just to make sure there's any loose material is gone. And then I'll put them in the cars. And I'll show you that a little bit later. Okay, load's pretty much dry now. As you can see, I put it in a car. You see, it looks pretty good. It's got a nice little profile. It fills the car rather nicely. And I think it's a nice, inexpensive way to fill up your hopper and gondola cars. So thanks for viewing. Thanks for watching. And good luck.